How many times have you sat down in front of the TV with the plan to just eat one cookie, and then you ate a lot more than one cookie? Carbohydrates, dietary fat, and sugar are not the causes of excess body fat. There's not one reason, there's more than one reason. Food is a business. It's a delicious business, but it's also a profitable business. And how do we sell more food? By getting people addicted to food. So it's not carbohydrates, it's not sugar that makes us diabetic. There are other factors, which I talk about in my other videos. There are two, and only two factors that matter, and that's... What is it that causes fat gain? Is it carbs? Is it sugar? Is it dietary fat? Is it a sedentary lifestyle? Well, the truth is that what really causes fat gain and diabetes is none of the above. And what is the actual cause? We'll talk about that at the end of this video, as well as what to do about it. Before we jump in, who am I? My name is Igor. I'm the author of a number of books on exercise and nutrition, including Stop Exercising the Way You're Doing It Now. As well, I run an online personal training company called Fitness Solutions Plus. We've been running it since 2010. Let's talk about the theory of how carbs cause fat gain. In theory, here's how it goes. When you eat carbohydrates turn to sugar or glucose. Glucose increases in the blood. When blood sugar goes up, insulin goes up. Insulin causes the body, the fat cells, to store everything. It stores the sugar, it also stores the fat. So if that was true and insulin was the greatest cause of fat gain, in theory, blocking insulin should cause fat loss, regardless of the calories. Well, that's actually not true. The biggest factor is calories. Lots of research has been done, and some of it is linked in the description below, where obese and overweight individuals are given the same number of calories, but one group of them is given an insulin-lowering medication, and the other one is given a placebo. At the end of these studies, fat loss and weight loss are identical. So insulin causes a lot of, excess insulin or deficient insulin causes a lot of issues, but fat gain is not one of those issues. Now, don't get me wrong, it's not good to have high insulin levels, but they're not the cause of fat gain. Maybe they're a contributor to fat gain, but they're not the root cause of fat gain. Furthermore, on a more practical level, the vast majority of the world is on a high-carb diet. For example, what do they eat in Asia? Largely rice. What do they eat in Europe? Potatoes and bread. What do they eat in South America? Corn. So these are sources of carbs, carbs, and more carbs. And yet, who's really got the obesity problem? Largely, it's North America and the UK. If carbs were the exact issue that causes fat gain, wouldn't you see larger amounts of obesity in China, in Japan, in Korea? Well, no, they have much lower obesity rates compared to North America and the UK. So no, carbohydrates are not the cause of fat gain. Carbs also don't make us diabetics either. The real issue is not carbs. The real issue is excess carbs. How do we know? Because in studies where carbohydrates are high in the total diet, but calories are low, people aren't diabetic. And furthermore, diabetics on a high-carb diet but a low-calorie diet reverse their diabetes. Another factor that helps with diabetes reversal, as I've talked about in many of my other videos, some of them linked in the description below, is fiber. Fiber is also a source of nutrients that helps reverse diabetes. So no, carbs don't increase diabetes and carbs don't increase body fat. Excess carbs do. And really, that's because of something else, which we'll talk about later in the video, so keep on watching. So if carbs don't cause body fat, people often think, well, what if it's dietary fat? Here's how that theory goes. Carbohydrates and proteins have 4 calories per 1 gram. However, dietary fat has 9 calories per gram. Therefore, it's dietary fat that causes fat gain. Well, no, not true. Not that simple. What really causes fat gain is not dietary fat, because we need dietary fat for different reasons. Dietary fat is necessary for hormone production. It's responsible for the cell membranes. It's responsible for the nervous system. We need dietary fat. We also need body fat. They're both responsible for a lot of healthy activities, healthy functions within the body. So no, dietary fat does not cause body fat. Excess dietary fat can cause body fat, just like excess carbs can cause body fat, excess body fat. There's not one reason. There is more than one reason. So the next theory is, well, maybe sugar. Sugar must have some kind of special properties that cause people to gain body fat. Well, the truth is it's actually not sugar either. In research where they try to determine, does sugar have some kind of properties beyond just the calories that makes it that makes people gain body fat? So to find out, there has been a number of studies done where one group of people is on a low sugar diet. 10% or less of their calories come from sugar. And another group of people are on a high sugar diet. 25% or more of their calories are coming from sugar. But the calories are even, and both groups lose the same amount of body fat and the same amount of weight. So no, there's no magical properties to sugar beyond just the caloric content. Likewise, sugar doesn't really make us diabetic either. Again, excess calories, excess sugar, and lack of fiber is what really makes us diabetic. So it's not carbohydrates, it's not sugar that makes us diabetic. There are other factors, which I talk about in my other videos. So we've learned that carbohydrates, dietary fat, and sugar are not the causes of excess body fat. What did I say? Here's a little clue. I said carbohydrates aren't the problem, excess carbohydrates are the problem. Dietary fat isn't the problem, excess dietary fat is the problem. Why are they problems? It's very, very simple. The only reason they're problems is because of excess calories. It's just excess calories that make us put on body fat. At the end of the day, fat loss is extremely simple. There are two and only two factors that matter, and that's total calories, total protein, and that's fat loss. Weight loss is even simpler. Total calories are the only thing that matters. Of course, I don't think you want to lose muscle, you don't want to lose bones, so we want to have adequate protein. And again, what's adequate protein? I've talked about in other videos, and there's a protein calculator on my site, linked in the description below. So it's really excess calories that make us put on body fat. Whether those excess calories come from carbohydrates or fats or any other sources, that's the real culprit. But there's a deeper question. Why are we consuming excess calories? Is it that we're not aware that we shouldn't be eating those excess calories? Well, no, we are aware. The thing is that food is a business. It's a delicious business, but it's also a profitable business. The idea of the food industry is to sell more food. And how do we sell more food? By getting people addicted to food. And how do you create food addiction? It's a very simple formula. There are only three ingredients to making food addictive. One, sweet. Two, rich. Three, artificial flavors. When you use that combination, it makes you want to eat beyond just the caloric value of that food. You're no longer just eating for hunger or satisfaction, you're eating for pleasure. Okay? You're hijacking the pleasure and reward system of the brain to make you want to eat more just because it tastes good, not because you're hungry. Think about it this way. In nature, you don't really have that combination of sweet plus rich plus artificial colors and flavors. Think about it this way. If something is sweet in nature, like a banana, it's not rich as well. If something is sweet in nature, like an apple, it's not rich as well. If something is rich, like an avocado, it's not sweet. If something is rich, like almonds, it's not sweet. Never in nature do we encounter sweet plus artificial colors plus rich. But in grocery stores, we do all the time. Ice cream, cookies, etc. That's the real combination that makes us crave more calories, excess calories beyond what we would consume rationally. How many times have you sat down in front of the TV with the plan to just eat one cookie and then you ate a lot more than one cookie? Happens all the time, right? On the other hand, how often is it that you sat down with the intention to eat one apple and by accident you ate three apples? You never hear that happening, or with banana or with cherries, etc., right? Because what's sweet in nature is not also rich. It doesn't create addiction. But the goal of the food industry is to create addiction to sell more food because it's a profitable business. And so if that's what causes us to gain body fat, what is the real solution to it? It's extremely simple. Don't eat things that are both sweet and rich and have artificial colors or flavors. So eat as many foods as you can that have one ingredient or more. For example, if you're in a grocery store and you're buying chicken, how many ingredients does chicken have? One, chicken. If you're in a grocery store and you're shopping for broccoli, how many ingredients does broccoli have? One, broccoli. But if you're in the grocery store and you're shopping for ice cream, how many ingredients does ice cream have? A lot more than just ice cream. Ice cream itself is not an ingredient, it's made of a bunch of different things. It's really that simple. If you just want to make fat loss extremely simple, just eat foods that have one ingredient. That's it. I hope you liked this video. If you did, click like and subscribe. It will help you learn when I publish more videos like this, and it will help other people with their fat loss as well. Thank you and goodbye.